get it? Woo! All right, that was good, right? Okay. All right, guys, you can chill out now. I'm going to give you a bunch of information that took me 2 years to discover, and now I'm going to give it to you in 40 minutes. So, first off, I want to say thank you so much for coming to this. I know it's the last day and kind of dragging, so I really appreciate it. I gotta be honest, when I even was actually looking at my own, I got the app for Be the Best, and I was looking at my own schedule arrival, and it said CUDIT Concentric hitting. So I even thought to myself, all right, here we go. Another new way to hit. Another coach that knows the best way to hit. Another philosophy that's the new best way to hit. I probably have to change everything. Some fancy words that I'm getting delivered to me. I actually myself was like, man, these people probably feel a little stressed out right now. So, first off, does everybody have a rubber band? We're gonna hand them out. Now, everything that I just described is everything that I personally cannot stand. I'll never forget, when I first opened my business 10 years ago, pretty old right now, I went on the internet like a lot of people do, and I started looking up hitting techniques, mechanics of the swing, the best way to hit. All I got when I shut down my computer, I felt completely stressed out. I felt like I had no idea of the words they were using. And I felt like, oh my gosh, I know nothing here. And I made it my mission to literally find a way to make it relatable to everyone with the highest performance level of the swing, or highest technique. So I went on a mission. But this all started with what you have in your hand. So does everybody have a rubber band?
Yeah.
Yes. I need one. Thank you. So this is the true story. So I was sitting in my office, and I'm like, you know, all these fancy ways to hit, and all these techniques, and all I did was study so many people talking, and they sounded really fancy and smart, but I couldn't relate to it, so how on earth could I relate that to a 10-year-old? So I said, I gotta find another way. And I have to base it off the science, and I have to base it off muscle movement. So I'm sitting in my office, and I had a hair tie. Guys, it's like a black thing you get from CVS, from Bowl. You usually lose them all the time. And I was playing with the hair tie, so take your rubber band. And I was playing with it, so it was just like this. And I thought to myself, what happens when your body does this? And I just kept doing this. Like, I just kept doing this. What happens? Because this is really what we want to accomplish, right? We want to accomplish that highest stretch of the body out and the highest muscle movement of the body to hit the ball with the most velocity and stay clean throughout it. So I started doing this and I put it down and I went on Google and I said, what happens when you stretch a rubber band? And that led me to 3 phases of muscle movement. Eccentric, the amortization phase, and concentric muscle movement. And I decided that I'm going to create a private lesson hitting certification program geared towards muscle movement. Not because I said so, not because I'm the next guru of this and that, not because I know fancy words. It's because it's based off of muscle movement. So I spent a lot of time developing CUDIT so that you never feel how I felt when I went on the internet that day. So what is CUDIT? After 2 years, I developed it and it's private lesson licensing system, It's drill interval training so you never stop throughout your lesson. Anybody ever hear of HIIT? High intensity, yeah. So I go to these HIIT workout classes, and you're targeting the muscle in a 3-part progression. Okay, so this kind of works here. So we do that with our drills. We take it from one level, and we make it a high level, and then we go down to the basics. So that when the ball's pinched to you, it seems really easy. And you never stop within your lesson, and you train the mind as well. So it targets muscle movement. It doesn't target because I said linear is the best. Because I said rotational is the best. I don't like this back and forth fighting on the internet. It's a bunch of egos that I just really can't handle anymore, to be honest with you. It's muscle movement, and that's what needs to be brought to the game with fast pitch. I watch these NCAA swings, and they're great, but I hate to tell you, it's missing something. It's missing a little more leg load in that bottom half with the leg lift. A little more aggressive action in the body. And again, it's not because I said so. My ego is not big enough. It's because it's based on muscle movement. It's based on science. And like I said, I don't do alternative facts. I do the actual facts. That's important to me. All right, so I was on a journey. That's me when I'm dressed fancy like I was demoing to. And I studied and I had to figure out how do you perform the highest level of the swing. So I went to acupuncturists. I went to physical therapists. I went to doctors. I went to actual therapists as well. And I took an 18-month endeavor to study how to develop the best private lesson and the best steps of the swing so that you never feel how I felt. And that's how CUDIT Concentric was born. So what on earth is concentric movement? Does anyone know? Besides from looking at this. I'm going to show you what it is. And it sounds really fancy, but it's really simple. So, Coach Liz, can you come up here, please? All right. So, Coach Liz, now I got to be honest with you guys. I had to change my whole way of teaching and hitting when I learned all this. So it was definitely a hit to my ego, but when you stop learning, you stop living. So I had to kind of suck it up and do it. So these are the three phases of muscle movement that CUDIT Concentric hitting is based on. You ready for this? It's really, really serious. Coach Liz is going to go down for a jump squat, so she's going to go down right now. Eccentric muscle movement. Eccentric. Anything under the load, the muscles under the load are eccentric. Right now, because she's sitting there, it's called the amortization phase, kind of like a mortgage loan. Amortization phase right now. She's sitting there. You really don't want to be in that because where's all your energy going? It's being wasted, right? But when she jumps up, the concentric phase, which is my favorite part of the squat jump and now of the swim. Thank you. Does that make sense? Okay. It made sense to me. So I said, all right, so let's take our rubber bands. I said, all right, I gotta use this stuff now. So we're not rubber bands, right? So let's take our rubber band and let's stretch it out. So here, let's just say this is our body. Eccentric, amortization, right? Concentric. Ah, you did it. It's not really good. But once you sit here, our bodies use this energy, so we can't sit here. So that's why when you load to explode, it's got to be in one swift motion. So you load up all the weight and you throw all that weight. Does this make sense? It just makes sense, right? It just makes sense. So I want to talk to you guys a little more in depth. Do you have the whiteboard? Perfect. And the markers are in that bed. So I'm a big believer in gathering everybody together and figuring out what you guys think. I think everybody's input is very important, okay? My way's not the highway, and I like to learn from everyone. So we're going to go through it. Okay. So let me ask you a couple questions. Based off like how many people raise their hands and so how many stances, how many of you guys feel, let's put this way, how many of you guys feel that there's one set stance that you should have? Raise your hand. Just kidding, you don't want to raise. Okay, good. Right, so please raise stance in zero. That's good. What about a toe touch? How many people feel that the toe touch is an aggressive way to attack the ball? Raise your hand. So we'll say like 20%. Okay. How many loads are there? So let's start like this. So we'll say, raise your hand if you feel that there's one load. Two loads?
I think there's different types.
Just loaded throughout the body, the whole body. So just consider the whole body throughout the motion. Raise your hand. Two loads? But you tell your player there's a load, right? So there's more than one. Two loads? have potential to explode.
She's working together, yeah.
Okay, perfect. One working together, let's write that. All right, explodes. How many explodes? One. Okay, so we got one. All right, so let's break this down. Because I honestly thought the same thing. I started a business based off of this. So do you know how it felt to tell my staff that, hey guys, you know, we gotta kind of pick up our game and train a little differently right now? So let's see if there's one load or not. So I'm in my stance here, right? Step one, we shift our body weight. Does everybody agree? Okay. What's the second load? Okay. So this is what CUDIT comes in. CUDIT concentric movement. What you see right now in the fast pitch world is this. The toe touch. But I want you guys to stand up for me, because it took me a little bit to, you know, understand this as well. And I want you guys to put your hands up. And I want you to go into not just a regular load, it's called a body weight load. So you're gonna load on your back side. Okay? Now I want you just to toe touch. So act like there's like you're just, you know, you're testing the water of a pool just to see if it's hot or cold. And you see that in the fast pitch world 90% of the time, right? The toe touch, quick toe. But now let's do this. Shake it out, neutral. Load